Ah, god damn it. Gotta do a part two of this as well. Not a really good feeling, to be honest. Really ain't. As the name suggests, dumbasses are dumbasses. This time of night. Everything at night actually becomes so much dangerously creepier. I don't know. Me and my arachnid folk, and there's Did I go that on camera? The light was flickering as holy fuck. I think so. But man, all those dots is practically spiders. Damn, that's many of them. I think I hold for them. One of them actually hatched spiders there. Came many small spiders and now they're grown. That's a huge spider as well. Wonder what kind it is. Oh, damn. Oh. That was an awful stench. God. Well, that statue ain't creepy enough. I'm hearing music coming from someone somewhere there. Might be the boat. That didn't freak me out at all. I noticed the sarcastic tone in my voice. Pretty much everything freaks me out. This is a well-populated, famous spot for people to camp. It's actually really creepy. It gives me the shivers. Church. Just order myself a Ouija board and go up to the church and just play with the Ouija board. Spiders overall. I'm going the same trip as yesterday, but backwards. not actually going to catch something in the act, some supernatural bird. Just by being here is creepy enough, I'm just saying. And now, and my arachnophobia really kicks in, and that's not a good thing. Oh, it's so creepy. Won't help me much if I actually I'm in the right areas. It's still creepy as fuck. It's not any leaves that actually make those noises, but it's something else. And now we actually come to one of the creepiest parts. The church and the cemetery. Here in our fair little town. In this angle, the church tower, yeah, I can't really see that here. The church tower actually looks like it's tilting a bit to the right. Thank you. that on camera, but I swear I heard someone screaming over there. Wouldn't surprise me actually, since this is where all the addicts hang out. Just beside the graveyard, which really gives me the chills, and it's not because it's a little bit windy outside. It's like a chill running down my entire back. To the core. I don't think I'm going to do any form of challenge today, but it's creepy enough to be here at night. Is a spider, isn't it? Dear God, I've come close to that, and of course it's there as well. positive side, I'm almost home. Negative side, I'm fried. No, not creepy at all. Just that the fact that the eye seems to be following you. So, no, it's not really that creepy. There's something moving over there. Not kidding. But I'm pushing forward, trying to gather all the strength that I have to actually push on. And not just freak out of panic and run so that I might actually trip. That happened to me actually at one point when I played with my Ouija board app. Oh. All of a sudden I felt this pressure on my chest. Like someone's grabbing and squeezing it really hard. Somewhere close by here, in this particular area, I saw something move. And at it was on the tree, since that tree I couldn't see from that corner when I was all the way back there. So it's pretty much impossible to see that tree over there. feel this pressure on my chest. This, that over there is actually wooden bridge. Was assembled, built, I think it's 2 years, between 1 and 3 years. Now when I actually promise, when I get to Circle K, I know that my midnight adventure is at an end. I live about, I don't know, the Pokemon Go app says that it's, and Google Map as well says it is about 400 meters or 1200 feet. But honestly, I'm really skeptical about that. Because it doesn't seem that much. Now that actually the eerie feeling has gone down, still the fact that there's quite a bit of spiders here ain't fun. I'm telling you, it's probably the most eerie thing of all. Do a midnight stroll like me, and if you're someone that's actually vulnerable to jump scares, there's not a whole lot of things that can actually keep you calm. And on top of this being a midnight stroll, I am deadly terrified of the dark. And I do mean deadly. It's like the things that I'm actually afraid of. Arachnids. Snakes, for some reason, not so much. I just think they're cute. But heights, what more? Recovered heights. Even though I'm not been to space, which hardly ever anyone has, I've read about this phobia that actually makes you think how small you are. You get this feeling of insignificance over yourself. You see the beautiful planet as it is, warts and all, and yet you can't really comprehend. It's actually too much for your brain, so you can actually be really intimidated by how insignificant you are. How small you are compared to pretty much everything that you see.
which might actually give you some panics. Now let's see if we can see. I can't see the stars. It might actually be light polluted skies or clouds in the skies. Oh, nothing to scare about this. Two or three streetlights just off. To be honest, I don't actually see any stars. Do you guys? Anyways, I'm back home. Get up to my apartment, which ironically is on the top floor. As far as the handle to the vacuum cleaner, haven't fallen down. Just gonna check. Yeah, it's locked. Anyways, guys, it's been fun. This is Mr. Dumbass signing off.